Hello student, welcome to the class. I'm Yogita. Our subject is CNET, Nursing Education for Nurses. And today we are going to discuss about non-projected graphic aid, cartoons and diagrams. Now first let us discuss about cartoon. I don't know what to explain. You may be very familiar with the cartoons because whenever you open your newspaper, any magazines, or when you check your message, WhatsApp messages, lot of cartoon images you may find, which make you to feel laugh, definitely. Now, cartoon is a humorous creature which also contains some strong messages which want to point out some important aspect of our environment, our society, or any educational aspect, and which want to give a strong information, a message to the audience. This is what called cartoon is. Now, how do we prepare this cartoon? That's very important because today we are talking about cartooning, which is very closely associated with the educational programs. Now, how do we prepare? Now, the cartoon that must meet the educational objective. It should catch the attention of a viewer. It should motivate them to learn. The exact message what you want to convey that must reach to the learner. Cartooning, it creates a kind of comedy, a humorous, where you feel relaxation when you read the content. Because seriously, we are reading a text, yeah, we are preparing for the topic. We'll be so exhausted, we'll be so serious. But in between this comedy, yeah, this cartoon, which make you to feel relaxed physically and mentally. So that capacity should be there in the cartoon. A cartoon, we should not divert the mind of a person. I mean, it should not be deviated from the educational object, because we are using it in our educational package as a tool of AVA. So here that must do its job. That's very important. Now, when we use this cartooning, what are the sources from where and all we can see these cartoons? Mainly some periodicals, newspapers, journals, magazines. Even they're talking about some political aspects, social factors, or some kind of social issues. They are illustrated very beautifully with the help of cartoons. The advantages of cartoon are definitely it will catch the attention of a learner. It motivates them. It will make them to feel relaxed when they go through these cartoons. It catch the attention. It helps the teacher to start the class with a bit of humorous, so that the entire class will be so lively, so that teacher is able to catch the attention of the student. Teacher can keep the students motivated in the subject. Okay, then what's the disadvantages? One thing, you must know how to make a drawing. It's not that easy to make a cartoon. We may feel laugh, but if you really try to do that, you'll understand how difficult it is. You need to know the drawing. One more thing, that there is no proper language. We are not using much words or sentences, so there is no language development of a learner. Definitely, some cartoons may hurt the individual personally. Their belief, their their personality might be got disturbed when you present such aids. Now, when a teacher is using a cartoon in a class, she might be more conscious when you select the material, because it should not hurt or disturb anyone. Sometimes what happens, students or the learner, they will take the cartoon, they will have that fun, but exact actual concept they will ignore. The negligence will happen. So this will be the one of the drawback of cartooning. So apart from that, cartoon is one of the most beautiful aid which make you to feel laugh, as well as what you studied that will retain, because your study is related to your mind, where your mind was completely relaxed. Okay, that's all about your cartooning. The next aid was, the next graphic, non-projected graphic aid is diagram. See, diagram means we are illustrating some pictures. You are drawing something. See, you are presenting some idea, some concept, some pictures, some illustration, with the help of pictures, diagram. You're drawing something that is what called diagram. Maybe you want to explain now heart. You're drawing the picture of your heart. Okay, this is called diagram. You wanted to draw something, how this, seed germination, a small concept for the small children. You are drawing a picture. First you put the seed, then you put some water, then small plant will come, germination. See, this is the way you are explaining with the help of your diagram. See, this is what called a diagram. Now, when and how do you prepare this diagram? It should be based on the concept what you are preparing. It should meet your educational need. It should complete the educational objective. Then diagram should be so closely related to your content what you are explaining. And you need to make a proper neat diagram. Overlapping of picture may lead to misunderstanding. So concept may not be so clear. Then the labeling should be done in the diagram. It should be a proper, neatly explained what you did in your diagram. That's all about your diagram. Definitely, maybe you will get a question. Usually, you will get a question in anatomy and physiology. Write the diagram of respiratory system and explain. That means first you need to draw the picture of particular system, then explain. See, what you're drawing, that is called as diagram. So, these two are the important very simple concept of this non-projected graphic aid, cartooning and diagram. Definitely you all can write, I guess. So I'll see you in the next class with the new concept. Please take care of yourself and thank you all.